From the beginning of time, there has always been chaos. Chaos creating planets, planets creating atmospheres, atmospheres creating ozones, ozones creating safety, and safety creating dance. This dance is between the atoms that make up life as we know it. Tonight, we will travel through time and space, exploring the history of one man who lives on the seventh planet of our solar system, Earth, the blue planet. To do this, we have literally made our spaceship go backwards, away from Mars and back to Earth, where we were able to capture a short interview with Glenn Joe.
I got started cross-country skiing in college. I was an alpine skier in college. And my senior year, I changed and went to cross-country because I wasn't going to make the alpine team. And that's where it all started, at University of Nevada, Reno, with cross-country skiing. And it just worked for me. The sport seemed to fit me and apparently my body style. When I was skiing, I had a teammate. His name was Lyle Nelson. He was four-time Olympian biathlete. And I think he's the one that inspired me and motivated me to pursue biathlon and do as well as I could back in the late 70s, early 80s. I think athletes, to be successful, have to have a varied lifestyle. And honestly, I think all the coaches that we deal with here in the West, including myself, would say mainly that we're teaching life skills, and there has to be a balance in life. There's athletics, there's other pursuits in life, and balancing that actually makes you become a better racer and better competitor, and in the end, better at whatever your chosen goal or pursuit is. When I started with Far West, I led my first junior national trip in 1977. And we took six kids to Deadwood, South Dakota. And the reason I got involved is when I was skiing, we didn't really have coaches for biathlon team. We pretty much did it ourselves. We'd have some training camps. And I've always wanted to see if I could at least provide the same opportunity for some of our local kids that I had. And since then, I've been involved with Far West since the late 70s. And I've taken some breaks. And then been real involved at other times, and through 2005, and then we started a biathlon program, and now I'm actively coaching full-time biathlon. In the early days of Far West, it was pretty low-key. We didn't really train on a weekly or monthly basis. We just had kids in high school programs that did well and was not really a tryout program. It was more if you wanted to go. We'd put the trip together and take you to junior nationals. Now it's evolved with all the great coaches we have and the great programs throughout Far West to a tryout system with probably more athletes than we can take on a trip, which has made it competitive and way more successful. For me, it's been really fun to see it go from a grassroots level to a very professional organization like it is today. I think for me, it's interesting, my lifestyle. I live in two different worlds. I grew up as a cowboy on a cattle ranch, and then I've spent the majority of my time since college coaching and competing in cross-country skiing and biathlon. And the animal that always grounds me and brings me back to who I really think I am is the horse. And I still ride a lot with local ranchers in Sierra Valley, and I still coach and compete in cross-country skiing here in the Truckee Tahoe area. So I think right now I have the best of both worlds and the two worlds I enjoy the most.
Bad feeling about this.
I think the goal's over the next rise.
What are you doing in my people's forest?
Please don't hurt us. We're just looking for gold.
Gold? I have gold. Come this way.
After.
Nation woman, how'd you get here so fast?
From my Nordic skis, they are the secret of the Nordor people. They fly like the wind, like an eagle in the trees. But you have these fat skis, and you clomp through the trees, and you cut down the trees, and you wreck the mountains, and you have baggy clothes, and you shred the gnar.
We just don't know any better.
That's enough. Just show us the gold.
Yeah.
I have the gold. But it is worthless. Except if you have Nordic skis. And then it is priceless. In the right conditions, it is beyond measure.
We promise not to use our bad skis anymore. You've convinced us. Bad skis.
I will give you each the special gold. And I will give you Nordork names. You will be Captain Nordic, knower of all things Nordic, and you will be El Jefe, master teacher of all those who aspire to Nordic.
Three-way high five! Woo!
Mark was my middle school Nordic coach, and he really got me into the sport as Nordic because before I wasn't really into it. And I have to thank Mark for getting me back into the sport Nordic skiing. And I really know him as like a cheerful guy, and I kind of look at him as sparkly humor, so I call him Sparkle Face, and it's kind of our little inside joke.
Jeff Slosh is really supportive, and he helps you out when you need it. He's really nice, and he has lots of fun fast facts.
With Mary Ellen, mostly, she's
just so nice, and every time I see her, she asks me how I'm doing and how my day is, and I'm also really jealous of her Beats Volkswagen Bug. I really want one.
Mark Nadel's a funny guy. I always love seeing him out on the trails in his crazy tights.
Well, Mark Nadel was like my first ski coach ever, so he kind of got me into Nordic skiing for the first time. I kind of thank him for getting me into the sport.
Mary Ellen is really funny and nice at all the times I've met her.
Mark Nadel, he's a funny character. Jeff is one of the most amazing coaches I've ever had. He's always encouraging me to push myself and kind of go beyond the boundaries that I kind of set for myself in my mind, and he's kind of amazing in that way.
Mary Ellen, she was on the first Nordic camp I ever went on, and I didn't know anyone there, but she was really supportive and she ran with me, and I had lots of fun driving with her. She's just really a great coach.
Mark Nadel is a great photographer that also knows a lot about skiing and really supports Far West.
Jeff Schloss is super nice, like a really nice guy. You know, everybody's fun. He's fun. Everybody's fun.
Jeff Schloss has really inspired me as a skier. He's been my coach. He's been my coach for 2 years, and I love just skiing with him and talking to him about training. And he's always super enthusiastic about skiing, and he's always having a good time, no matter if it's raining, snowing, or sunny. It doesn't really matter. He loves it.
Mary Ellen's also a great coach, just like a lot of the other coaches. She's super nice and is always giving us the best push we can to succeed.
Mary Ellen's a great coach. She's very nice and helpful, and she's a really good coach. I like her, she's helpful a lot.
Mary Ellen, I think, is a lot like Mark. Like, sometimes she's strict and stuff, but she's also super fun and funny, and yeah.
I have really vivid memories of Mark Nadel at middle school races just being coated in glitter, and then weeks later he would tell me how he still found like glitter particles on his pillow, and I'm really glad I made that impact on his life.
Jeff, when I came to Sugar Bowl, he was a super friendly and motivating coach, and I kind of looked up to him, and he was always there smiling and like encouraging you at the workouts and having fun at the workouts, and kind of showed you how to that workouts aren't just working, it's also super fun activities.
Time keeps on slipping, slipping, slipping into the future. Time keeps on slipping, slipping, slipping into the future. I wanna fly like an eagle to the sea. Fly like
an... We haven't really established a nickname. She's Mother Bear. She's Mother Bear. She's the mother to us.
Oh yeah, she's a friggin' god. She's amazing. She's just, yeah, she's a god.
She's been coaching since 1993, so 23 years.
She's a pretty rad gal. She's a good coach.
Oh wait, Shane, that's right. Shane, one day for some reason about 3 years ago, we decided to gender swap everyone. So every boy received a girl name and every girl received a guy name. And Shane just clicked with us for some reason. I don't know.
Oh, I remember once we went roller skiing and she found this dead bug on the side of the road. And then she threw it at Lucas. And yeah.
She'd yell at me all the time from the sidelines.
We've determined that she was a cheetah from her primal zodiac sign.
Well, I'm known for falling all the time when I roller ski. But every time that I do, Nancy always has like this huge like selection of first aid equipment for me.
If Nancy were to write an autobiography, it'd be titled something having to do with Nordic racing.
She pushes us hard. She's been a great coach for the past 4 years in high school.
She said that her worst race experience was that once in the Calgary Olympics, like right out of the start, her clister grabbed, and then she just fell in the stadium.
So Nancy's best race was in Lahti, Finland, and she got 15th place and a 15K classic individual start. And she scored World Cup points.
She's a really good coach. She just gets really personal with each of her athletes and knows every person well and knows how to get every person to do their best.
She deals with our shenanigans every day.
She's just an awesome coach.
Just by knowing Nance, like something wise, like a tortoise, but she's a fast tortoise. Don't underestimate her. She's got some fight in her.
Suspecting stranger had better know the truth of wrong from right. 'Cause the eyes of the ranger are upon you. Any wrong you do, he's gonna see. When you're in Texas, look behind you. 'Cause that's where the ranger's gonna be.
Pretty taken up with my training regimen.
Your mother's right, though. We need your help on this gigantic farm of ours. We have so much land. We need your help. What are you using those poles for? Those are for plowing the fields.
Oh, Dad, these are for going fast on my double pole.
Let me see those. Give me those poles.
What the hell are those things?
So light.
That's right. It's so I can win races.
These are for poking the fire.
Ah, I see.
Yep. Are these expensive?
Mom, everybody else on the team has nice poles like this. What, do you want me to lose races because my poles weigh 100 pounds?
I don't want you racing at all. I want you helping out on the farm.
These are like light as a cigarette. They don't need to be that light.
Listen, son. Nordic skiing is for weirdos. You're prancing around in your tightly colored lycra. We need your help here at home with our livestock and our crop.
Well, I actually have been thinking about really reducing my training load a lot in the future.
Oh, that means you can help out with the farm? You're going to be around?
Actually, I've been meaning to tell you guys, but I just took a job in the big city. I'm moving to Cable. I'm going to be a ski coach.
Cable Wisconsin?
Cable, Wisconsin. It's the bright lights. Big city.
I don't know what to say. This is all so overwhelming.
What about us?
Yeah, do they even pay you to do that?
Well, I want to follow my dreams, and I've been a Nordic skier for so long. It means so much to me to be involved in the sport that I want to finally give back to some other younger kids. I think I can really make a positive impact.
But who's going to play with the puppies?
And who's going to chase all the chickens?
And we were just about to get into octopus farming, too. Who's going to take care of all of them?
It's horrible news. Horrible news.
Mom and Dad, don't you see this is actually a good thing? I mean, I'm going to follow my dreams. I'm going to help young kids who really need a role model. They need help learning how to ski as fast as they can, and they need to motivate for that. I'm going to be able to help them follow their own dreams and actually learn how to be, you know, hardworking and disciplined and, you know, passionate about something that they really want to do. And, you know, I know it's not the same thing as helping out here on the farm, but I do feel like I can make my biggest impact away in the cable and helping coach these kids.
Well, Tina, I guess our other 11 children could help out around the house and the farm.
True, dear, true.
If Ambrose does want to pursue his dreams in cable in the big city, I guess we gotta let him go.
Yep. Spread your wings and fly. On the show.
Golly, Mom. I'm so glad to hear you say that.
With my thoughts move so slow, I've got where I should be. Cause here my thoughts are free.
Ambrose is pretty nice. It's nice to have him around just as help, and he's always fun to talk to. He always sits with us at lunchtime, which is pretty cool. I say everyone on the team kind of just like has a pretty good relationship with Ambrose.
All right, so if I was to pick a spirit animal for Martin, I'd probably pick a deer or a kangaroo or something with a lot of hops, because when you watch Martin bound, it's pretty impressive. And Hawkrest, you agree? Yeah, that's Martin's spirit animal.
If I were to have to pick a spirit animal for Ambrose, I'd say it'd be a bear, because he's really big and pretty powerful but pretty funny, and like a bear, he seems to get sleepy sometimes, so that'd be Ambrose's spirit animal.
I think Tina's spirit animal is a chipmunk, because last year when we were in Marine camp, we were playing a game where each of us kind of chose our favorite animal, and we mimicked it and made the noise and kind of acted like it. And after that, I've kind of just like looked at Tina and like thought, oh, she's a chipmunk, because I just find chipmunks super energetic and like want to run around. And Tina's super energetic, and she, whenever you're like racing, she'll be like super motivating and hyped. And I just kind of picture that as chipmunks being super hyped about everything.
What I like about Martin is he like pushes me to do things like I just did. And I didn't really want to do 7 intervals. I was thinking about 5, and I did 7. And so he just pushes me to get better every day. Stop me. And yeah, my coaches really push me, and they make me better, and they want me better. And I like that.
To be perfectly honest, I have no idea how old Ambrose was when he started skiing, but I can just kind of imagine him as this like very tall, small, not small, very tall, like young kid, just like flailing around on skis, not really knowing what he's doing. Martin's pretty cool, like as a coach. Like, he comes off as intimidating at first, but he's kind of what I call fake intimidating. Like, once you get to know him, he's actually pretty funny, and he's really willing to help you and work with you on technique and anything. And I just think he's very like there for you as a coach. Like, he's a very attentive coach, and works like to find details with each kid, which is pretty cool.
Christina. I like Christina. She has a lot of intensity and
Dude, Spike, go like that.
She is a really good training partner, actually, and she's really intense.
Tina's just amazing. She's like an older sister to me. She's my point person, my Nordic coach, my art teacher. I talk to her about everything. It's like way beyond coaching.
There was this one time my coach, Martin Benish, skied over me in Mammoth. Got all this hard wax all over my brand new Sugar Bowl jacket.
Christina's awesome. She was just so welcoming when I was new to the team this year. She took me out for like a private ski session, which I still think was like one of the most beneficial things to my training this summer. She just worked with me on everything I needed to work on. She was just really like open-armed and just really willing to help and super supportive.
Vím, že láska dým, proto teď tu hlásat smím. Noc, když zavzdychá, tak se hned oheň rozdmychá. Nápěv písní, co se proslýchají, tady zpívám těm, co teď možná lásku tají. Je to zlé, 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 hoří jak trou, hoří jak trou. Nápěv písní, co se proslýchají, tady zpívám těm, co teď možná lásku tají. Je to zlé, 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 hoří jak trou, hoří jak trou. Dusí mě kouře sloup a vím, že klesám hloub. Přesto vzdávám lásce dík.
Alushka's a really great coach and she knows a lot about skiing. She teaches us a lot of technique and is really clear on what we have to do to get better. And it has made me a lot better skier since she's been our coach.
Well, Alushka is a super good coach. Pretty strict sometimes, but you know, that's always good. She has a good balance of strict and fun. And yeah, her training plans are awesome, and there's a lot of things that are awesome about her.
Alushka's a really good coach, and she teaches us great things on technique and everything you need to know for Nordic. And I really like the way she's coaching us and the hard training she gives us to make us better skiers.
Alushka's a great coach. She's always has a special way of what we do, and is always pushing us to do our best. So yeah, she's a great coach.
Alushka's an amazing coach. She has tips to help with almost everything, and she's really helpful, and whenever you're not skiing right or something like that, she'll explain how to do it right, and then you can do figure out what you're doing wrong, fix it, and then you'll be good again.
She brings a bunch of, she brings happiness and smiles also, and she's always trying, and she's always smiling.
Eliska is a really great coach, and when you're skiing, she teaches you a lot of techniques. Whenever you're doing something wrong, she comes over to you and helps you out. And that's all.
I really like Eliska as a coach. She's great. She's really helped us push our to our best. She's just overall a really good coach, and I'm really happy to have her on TXC.
I think Tobias is a great coach because he encourages us to push harder and be better skiers.
Tobias is a great coach because he pushes us to our limits and makes every practice fun.
He brings smiles, he never quits, and he's always trying his hardest.
Elias is really fun, and he's also a great coach. He was really helped the organization come back to life, and I'm really glad that I could have him as a coach for a year.
Elias, like, always fun. He's super nice all the time. He's super good with kids and just always fun.
Elias just a really funny and awesome coach, and he's always having fun and laughing, and it's really fun to have him as a coach.
Elias awesome. We always have super fun with him, but still get all the training we need.
Elias an amazing coach, and he's really good at making everything fun, but still get all the training in, and he's a cool coach.
So Elias also a really great coach. When you fall, he comes over to you and helps you get back up. And also, when Elishka's not there, he's always there to coach us, and he's a really great coach to help.
Elias Gordon, great, great coach. I like him. We had a lot of fun with him while he went, when he was our coach.
Det var en gång två systrar i en liten by. Den ena var begagnad men den andra var ny. Den ena var charmerande, den andra var skön. Den ena var rätt krånglig men den andra var grön.
Amigo, you ain't welcome around these parts.
I heard round town there's a warrant out for your arrest. I'm gonna come collect.
Enough chit chat. Let's handle this like he coaches.
When I hear the words creative, funny, and just awesome in general, I think of Gus and Charlie, aka Gussel and Chuckweed, my amazing coaches at Auburn Ski Club, who push every athlete on the team to their limits every day at practice and also make it the most enjoyable training in Tahoe Truckee.
Okay, one thing I really love about Gus is how he always takes time to explain stuff to us and show us how to do it so we can ski better, whether it's between technique or just speed, how to make sure that we're going faster and skiing better. And I love that Chuck is always super fun and has a lot of fun and then makes everybody else have a lot of fun. But he's also really good about explaining technique and stuff like that to us.
Hi, we're the coaches at Auburn Ski Club. I'm Gus Johnson.
I'm Charlie Faraday.
Also known as
Chuckleberry Finn, Chuck Weed, Chuck Danger,
Gussel, Gussel the Muscle, and Gustache.
I started skiing when I was 15 years old.
And I started skiing when I was 2 years old.
My favorite memory from being a junior is inside jokes in the van, you know, just like.
And my favorite memory from when I was a junior was playing Felon in the dark, trying to avoid other kids and coaches in West Yellowstone. My most inspirational skier in my career has been Lucas Bauer due to his beautiful skiing.
My most inspirational skiers are Jeff Schloss because he's such a nice guy, and Bill Hokanson because he's done just so much good stuff for the sport. It's unbelievable. My most unusual talent is being able to be such a great backwards runner.
And my most unusual talents include my amazing Harry Potter knowledge and spontaneous dancing. Okay. All right, my best ski result was a 13th place at Junior Nationals in a classic sprint race.
My favorite race was at the New Mexico Invitational in the team time trial. My worst racing experience, the rain was just it was coming down. I couldn't do anything about it. I just had to push through.
And my worst race experience was at Soldier Hollow when I broke my toe, my ski, and my face.
It's
That's all right. Thanks, man.
All right, the best moment of my coaching experience was coming up with the Mini Ponies mascot.
My most hilarious coaching experience was when the battery was stolen out of the van and we just had to run all the way home. My spirit animal is an orca because it's big and strong, like the guzzle, the muscle.
And my spirit animal is the orangutan because I'm so silly and long.
I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations.
Somehow closer now. Softly smile, I know she must be kind.